Good morning dear students, welcome to our computer class. In this video we are going to discuss our third chapter, word processor and introduction. Do you know what is word processor? Word processors are the softwares used to type and edit. Can you say examples for these word processors? That means the softwares used to type and edit. Yes. WordPad, Notepad, MS Word. These are the commonly using word processors. We are going to discuss the word processor MS Word or Microsoft Word. MS Word is an application software used for word processing. Microsoft Word or MS Word was introduced by Microsoft, one of the world's largest companies in software development. This software has the power and flexibility too. That means these are the uses of Microsoft Word. Which are they? First one, produce letters, reports, notices, newsletters, books, bills, etc. The next use is beautify the text using color, style, font size, border, shading, various effects, etc. In MS Word, we can modify the words or text using different colors, styles, font size, by giving borders, shadings, and by giving different effects like that. We can modify in MS Word. Third one, in MS Word, we can use various drawing tools to draw pictures. Different tools are available in MS Word to draw the pictures. Fourth one, copy and move text from one location to another. We can move the text from one location to another in MS Word. Then the fifth one, preview the text before taking printout. Take multiple printouts. We can take the preview of the printout before taking the real printout of that page. And also we can take multiple printout. Now, do you know how can we start MS Word in our computer? This is what we are going to learn next. Starting with Microsoft Word. To open MS Word, first you have to click on Start button at the bottom corner of the desktop. Then select all programs from the start menu. Then what to do? Click on Microsoft Office and then select Microsoft Word 2010. Then Microsoft Word 2010 will be open. Now can you say the steps to open MS Word? Yes. First, click on Start button. Then all programs. Then Microsoft Office. Next, click on Microsoft Word 2010. Dear students, when you open MS Word, the first window or first page will be like this. Here, next we are going to learn about the components of Microsoft Word. Let's discuss few important components of MS Word. First one, title bar. Can you find out the title bar in the picture? Yes, title bar is on the top of the screen. Next is quick access toolbar. It is present on the title bar. It contains buttons for the most frequently used commands. Next is ribbon. Ribbon is located just below the title bar. Listen children, I'll show you the first window of MS Word in my computer. Here, the top portion of the screen is called title bar. The top left corner of the title bar shows quick access toolbar. And the next one, what we have discussed now? Yes, ribbon. Where is ribbon? Ribbon is located just below the title bar. This long rectangular space is called ribbon. This ribbon contains several tabs on it, such as File tab, Home tab, Insert tab, Page Layout tab, like that. The next component of Microsoft Word we have to learn is File tab. File tab is the first tab on the ribbon. On clicking this File tab, we can create a new file, open an existing file, save a file, print a file, and perform so many other tasks also. Listen, I'll show you the File tab. On this rectangular space which we call ribbon, the first tab on ribbon is File tab. We click on this File tab, we can see the options: create a new file, open an existing file, save a file. Okay. Next is working area. It is a large area where you can type, edit and format the text. Working area means the white space where we are typing in Word. Next component in MS Word is ruler. For what we use ruler? Yes, it's for taking measurement. In MS Word also we are using these rulers for taking measurement. MS Word, there are two rulers: horizontal ruler and vertical ruler. Horizontal ruler means what? Horizontal ruler will help you to take the measurement from left to right or from right to left. Then what is vertical? From top to bottom or bottom to top. In that direction, if you want to take any measurement, vertical ruler will help you to take the measurement. We can set the left margin, right margin, top margin and bottom margin with this horizontal ruler and vertical ruler. Next is scroll bar. In MS Word, there are two scroll bars: vertical scroll bar and horizontal scroll bar. We can move the screen display towards right or left using horizontal scroll bar and scroll it up or down with the help of vertical scroll bar. Next component is status bar. It is located at the bottom of the page. It displays the page number and number of words typed in this page and zoom options. At the right side you can see zoom. We can zoom in and zoom out the page. Dear students, in the next video we will learn about how can we type in this MS Word, how can we do editing like cut, copy, paste in MS Word, and how can we save a Word file. Watch this video and learn the simple topics what we have discussed in this video. Thank you.